Hi everybody. Putting to one side the dramatic intro to this video today, we're looking at the latest product from Smartmi, the Smartmi Air Purifier 2, which according to the box comes with a pollen filter, which like their other purifiers allows for excellent filtering and cleaning of the air surrounding you in your home. It works with HomeKit, Amazon and Google, but does offer a few extras. The first of these is a built-in VOC sensor, which wasn't in the P1 but was in their original air purifier. The big question, of course, is can this replace your existing VOC sensors? Well, the answer at present is a big fat no, unfortunately, as you'll see later. Possibly a more pertinent upgrade is a UV light that's designed to tackle bacteria and viruses in tandem with the filter, which we'll touch on in a bit. But for now, a quick comparison to the P1. This new model dwarfs the P1 by a good 20 centimeters, and with the increase in size comes a larger filter and therefore cleaning capabilities as shown in the specs. Feel free to pause the video at this point. Smartmi made the wise decision to make the body plastic and not metal, or it would probably be a lot heavier. Let's have a closer look now, starting with the back of the device, where there's a button on the top end that allows you to adjust the display brightness, and above that is a sensor for detecting VOCs. Below that is a latch to access the filter. Now this is different from the P1, where the filter is removed from the base. This makes sense, as this means you don't have to lift the purifier to access the filter. At the bottom is the power port, which takes a 2-pin power cable, although as you'll see later, the cable isn't quite standard as it's designed to connect in a specific way. Finally, we have the laser particle sensor for detecting particulate matter, otherwise known as PM2.5 or PM10. There's also a separate temperature and humidity sensor, although these last two sensors are not exposed to HomeKit, unfortunately. Aside from the purifier, you get a manual in English and Spanish, along with the aforementioned power cable. And as you can see here, one end is squared off, so the cable can only sit in one way. Onto the control panel, and upon powering up, the purifier will tell you how much filter life is left. This will only show up when it has previously been disconnected from power. After that, the display shows a set of information all accessible in the one area. The only other button on the screen is for cycling through the different modes, which we'll see in a moment. The display has a pollen icon at the top to indicate PM levels, along with a colour ring encircling the display that reflects combined air quality levels. It should be noted that the display only shows temperature in Fahrenheit, not Celsius, which is clearly a bug in need of fixing. The mode button simply cycles through manual, auto and sleep modes, with manual allowing fan speed adjustment, but only via the app. Despite what one online review claims, the filter used in this purifier is not the same as the one used in the P1, even if it functions the same. The filter has a section where presumably you can place a sticker to remind yourself when the filter was installed, although the apps will tell you when it's time to change it anyway. Like most filters, this comes with a little handle to help you remove it from the purifier with just a little tug. As this is a 4-stage HEPA 13 filter, it's going to do a pretty good job at capturing almost everything floating around in your home, along with help from the UV light, of course. One nice update is the ability to remove the grill, although beware that little screw as it's easy to lose, which was nearly the case on my very first attempt at removing it. Another new feature is the option to dim the display or turn it off. Only the two buttons remain on at all times, although they're not very bright. It's time to put the sensors to a couple of quick tests, and for this I'm going to use some smoke from a stubbed out matchstick or two to test the PM2.5 sensor, and some rubbing alcohol to test the VOC sensor. In both cases, the purifier will be set to auto so that it can react autonomously. In this first test for the PM2.5 sensor, it took around 13 seconds for it to pick up the smoke and increase the fan speed to start removing the smoke particles. Now, as you can see, the PM2.5 number raises in tandem with the pollen icon and the outer ring, which both change colour to indicate the different level pollutions. Putting the fan in manual mode at top speed took around 3 minutes to clean up, with auto mode taking just under 5 minutes due to the fan decreasing in power as pollution levels went down. Next is the VOC sensor test, which didn't go so well, unfortunately. Whilst the display showed the VOC levels increasing, the fan speed only increased to a small degree, which wasn't nearly enough to tackle the polluted air. That's not the only issue, however, as I'll explain next.
So as you can see here, the TVOC sensor is showing that the levels are high, but if I go into my accessories, it's showing excellent. If I go into my Smartmi app, you can see the levels are poor, which is correct.
Putting that bad news to one side, I'll now quickly test the fan noise levels with the fan set to sleep mode first. This seems to average out at about 35 dB, which is pretty quiet in my opinion, even if it seems louder than the official numbers. Sleep mode is the equivalent of 7% fan speed. This next test has the fan at 100%. The sound levels seem pretty much to tally with the official numbers at roughly 64 dB, which is definitely loud and not something you want running at night, as obviously this is only designed for removing heavy pollution in a quick and timely manner. Let's have a look at what the apps offer, and for the home app you get the one tile along with controls for power and fan speed, which can be adjusted in 1% increments. Going a little deeper reveals two accessories which give access to more purifier settings, which are the same controls we've already seen, but with the addition of manual and auto mode buttons, a different fan speed slider, as well as filter details. What is missing are things like UV light control, a child lock, and control over the display brightness. For the air quality tile, this reveals overall air quality along with PM2.5 levels. There's no detailed info on VOC levels, however. If we now go into the Smartmi Link app, from the main screen you can select all of the different modes, and if you're in custom or manual mode, you can adjust the fan speed, which is shown in terms of room size. Temperature and humidity levels are shown at the bottom, and when expanded, this also reveals control over nearly all other aspects of the purifier, including the filter, screen brightness, and a delayed power-off function. In addition, you also get control over the UV lamp, a child lock feature, as well as control over the confirmation sound that comes from the purifier every time you change a setting, which to be honest is quite loud. From the main screen you get access to graphs on the VOC and PM2.5 levels, although once again these aren't especially detailed. When it comes to UV light, I don't have any equipment to test whether this is effective against bacteria and viruses, although this is a proven and reasonably effective technique anyway, so I'm happy to take their word for it. Finally, to our pros and cons section, and although it's a well-built and thought-out product, there are a couple of large issues which I really hope can be addressed with a firmware update soon. So first off, it's good to finally have an alternative to my now aging Vocalink PureFlow, and at a more reasonable price. Some of the improvements over both the original air purifier and the P1, like control over the display and a removable grill, are nice touches, and as I was a fan of the display on the P1, it's good to see that they've increased the size and overall functionality over the original model. The UV light is a timely and welcome addition to cleaning your air, although you should still take all precautions when it comes to germs and viruses, of course. Onto the cons, and it's a shame that most of the extra features aren't accessible via HomeKit, like the child lock or screen control, and when it comes to the disparity between the VOC readings in the Smartmi app and HomeKit, this makes the VOC sensor all but useless for automations, so I really hope they can fix this. That's my brief take on the Smartmi Air Purifier 2, but if I've missed anything or you have any other questions, feel free to ask away in the comments section. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. Until the next time, stay safe and buy some balloons.